In this video, I will give an overview of DAC, shortened data acquisition, and how we can use DAC with Python. I will exemplify this tutorial by reading temperature data using a DAC device called NI-USB-TC01 thermocouple. So that's a temperature device using the thermocouple device, and the device is made by NI or National Instruments, which is a vendor of DAC hardware and DAC software, including the popular LabVIEW software. But we will not use LabVIEW to read data from this DAC device. We will use Python instead. Before we start, I will just introduce some of my Python resources. I have made different Python resources, including some textbooks. This topic is taken from the Python for Science and Engineering textbook, which you find here at my webpage. I have also made other resources. If you are new to Python programming, I recommend the Python programming textbook. If you want to use Python for control engineering, I have made a textbook called Python for Control Engineering. And I also have a textbook called Python for Software Development. You find all these resources at my webpage. So the context of this tutorial, how can we use NI hardware with Python? So NI is hardware from NI hardware is hardware from the NI company, shortened National Instruments. I will explain what DAC is, or data acquisition is in general, and we will use this NI-TC01 thermocouple device as a as an example in the Python examples. Since this is a NI DAC device, it needs to have the DAC driver called DAC-MX. So I will give an overview of the driver you need, and in order to communicate with the driver from National Instruments, you need also a Python library or a Python API that communicates with the DAC driver and the DAC device. I provide lots of Python examples, including logging data, temperature data, plotting data. I will also show how to save the temperature data to a text file. Before we go further, the Python examples provided here will work with all NI DAC devices using this NI DAC MX driver from National Instruments. And NI has probably several hundred different DAC devices that can be used in combination with this DAC driver. But in this tutorial, we will use this NI-TC01 thermocouple DAC device as an example. And also, if you don't have a DAC device from National Instruments, the concepts, the basic DAC concepts, can also be applied to other types of hardware from other vendors. So basically, how can we use hardware from NI, the National Instrument Company, together with Python? Typically, NI, they create both lots of hardware, and they create software which can be used in combination with the hardware. And the most famous software from NI is the LabVIEW software, which is great to use in combination with their own hardware. LabVIEW is a graphical programming language, and typically use LabVIEW in combination with the with this NI DAC hardware from National Instruments. But the NI DAC hardware and the NI DAC MX driver can also be used in combination with other programming languages like C, C Sharp, Python, MATLAB, etc. And in this tutorial, we will control and use this NI DAC device from Python using this NI DAC MX driver, which is a free download from the NI webpage. So here you see an overview of the different components you need in order to perform data logging using this hardware from NI or National Instruments. So we, of course, we need a hardware, an NI-DAC hardware. In this case, we will use an TC01 thermocoupled from National Instruments. It is USB based, so you just plug it in into your USB connection to your computer and start using it. In addition, we need to install the hardware driver from National Instruments called NI-DAC MX driver. It's a free download. You can download from their home page. In addition, of course, you need the Python programming language, which is also free to use and free to download. In addition to the driver Python, you also need this NI-DAC MX Python API, which is also free. It's an API that communicates with the driver and the hardware from your Python programming code. It's also free, and it's made by the same persons that has made the DAC MX driver, which is National Instruments. So they work very well together. And of course, when you have installed this package and have an hardware available, you are ready to start creating your Python application. Here you see an overview of some of the hardware which is available from National Instruments. As mentioned, we will use this device, the TC01 thermocouple device, which is used to measure temperature. And you just plug it into your USB connection and attach it to your computer. All the hardware are USB 6008, CDAC, MyDAC, etc. They probably have several hundred different DAC devices that will work in combination with this NI-DAC MX hardware driver. So here you see the NI-USB TC01 thermocouple in more details. You have a USB cable, and you have this piece where you connect your thermocouple sensor directly into this this piece, and then you can choose between different thermocouple sensors. For instance, this one, this J-type exposed junction thermocouple, or in this case, this is the device I am having, a J-type grounded probe thermocouple. With this probe, it's easy to take measurements. You can put it into liquid, etc., to measure hot liquid or cold liquid. Just put it into the liquid without destroying it. If you want to learn more about this device, you can take a look at the webpage at the vendor's homepage. So the NI thermocouple device is a hardware made by National Instruments, or NI. It measures temperature using the thermocouple principle, and it's can be connected with different types of thermocouples. In our example, I will use this J-type. So let's dig into some details regarding DAC, or data acquisition. To read sensor data, you typically need a DAC device, which you connect to your computer. And you can also use devices like Arduino, Raspberry Pi, etc. But typically use a specific DAC device, which you typically connect to your computer using, for instance, USB. But in all cases, you will typically need to install a driver from the vendor of the DAC device or the sensor you are using. A DAC system typically consists of four different parts. You have the physical input-output signals and sensors. You have the DAC device or the DAC hardware. You have the driver software from the vendor of the hardware. And you have your software application. In this case, we will use the Python programming language. So here you see an overview of this DAC system. You have these input-output signals. It could be analog signals, digital signals. It could be different types of sensors. In this tutorial, we will use a temperature sensor using the thermocouple principle, and the sensor could be analog or having a digital interface. And these signals or sensor you typically connect to a DAC device, and the DAC device has some analog input output, and it has some digital input output. So this is the a typical DAC hardware, and then you connect this DAC hardware to your computer, typically using USB, Wi-Fi, etc., or even Ethernet connection. And then on your PC, you need to install the hardware driver, and then also in this case, we need to have this Python API, which communicates with the hardware on the hardware driver, and the driver again communicates with the DAC device, which communicates with this this real world using sensors and different types of signals. And on top here you have your application, and in our case we are going to create this application in Python. Before we go further, just a little bit about digital signals. In the digital world, you are not able to log data continuously, so you log data at specific intervals, like this. And the time between two logged values is called the sampling time, or shortened TS. And in the continuous world, we have T, which is the continuous time, but in the discrete world, we have typically use K, which is a discrete time. And then we can convert between the discrete time and the continuous time based on this sampling time, TS. Back to the NI DAC MX driver. It's a software that you can use to communicate with your DAC devices from National Instruments. One drawback is that this NI DAC MX supports only the Windows operating system. Typically, you will use LabVIEW, which is a software from NI, in combination with their own hardware to create the DAC applications. But since they have made this DAC MX driver that is can also be used in combination with other programming languages like C# and Python, we can easily create applications in different programming languages and communicate with the hardware from NI. And also this DAC MX driver is free, and you can download it from their webpage. So when you have the hardware ready and you have installed this driver, we are soon ready to start creating our application in Python. And next we need to configure the hardware. And typically, as part of this NI DAC MX software, there is a configuration tool called Measurement and Automation Explorer, or shortened MAX, which we can use to configure and test the device before we start creating the Python application. So let's start by connecting our DAC device to our computer using the USB port. Like this. And then this pops up, NI USB TC01. NI device monitor. Then we can choose what to do with the hardware, and typically we select configure and test the device using this measurement and automation explorer. So just click go here, and this measurement and automation explorer will pop up. And here you see this measurement and automation explorer software. And here you see a list under devices and interfaces. You find the list of the hardware you have connected to your computer. And here I find NI USB TC device. And it also has a name by default. You can also right click on it and click rename. By default, it has the name device 1, but I'm already having an other NI DAC hardware, which already have the name device 1. So typically then the next device will be called device 2, etc. But you can also specify your own name by just right click and select a proper name. I have chosen to call it just TC01. And this name we will need to use in our Python application. Next, here we can click self-test in order to make sure that the device is working properly and connected to your computer properly. And here you can also change the name from here. Here you see the vendor, the model, serial number, etc. And you also can click on the test panels. And then, since this thermocouple DAC device has only one analog input, namely analog input 0, we choose this channel and then select the proper type. We have a thermocouple. You can set the limits choosing units. I'm from Norway, so I prefer degrees Celsius. Thermocouple type, I'm using a J type. And this one is just built in. And then I can click start. And here you see the actual temperature measured by this thermocouple sensor. So this indicates that the sensor has been properly connected to your PC. And the driver, this NI DAC MX driver, has been properly installed. So now we are ready to go to soon start creating our Python application. I can just click stop here. So the final step before we can start creating our Python application is to install this NI DAC MX Python API. And this needs to be installed to make it possible to communicate with this NI DAC MX driver. So you need before we install this API, you need to have this NI DAC MX driver installed, either the full package or the runtime, which you can download from this location. And this API can be downloaded using the PEEP installation procedure, which is part of Python, and you just type PEEP install NI DAC MX like this. Here you see an example. Since I installed Python using the Anaconda distribution, and I will use this spider editor later, I can use this Anaconda prompt in order to install this NI DAC MX Python API package. So I just type PEEP install NI DAC MX in order to install this API. So on my computer, I just search for this Anaconda prompt, which I find here, open it, and then just type PEEP install NI DAC MX, which is this Python API, which we need to use in order to communicate with the driver. I just click enter. And then I have now installed this API, and I'm hopefully ready to start creating my Python application. So now we are ready to start creating our Python application, and here is our basic example. We need to start using import NI DAC MX, which is this NI DAC MX API, which you need in order to communicate with the driver from National Instruments. First, we need to create a task, so equals to nidocmx.task, just to start a task, and then we can specify what kind of task. In this case, it's an analog input channel, which we need to add, and we will use this thermocouple channel. And here we specify the name of the DAC device. This is TC01, which is the name we specified in this MAX, Measurement and Automation Explorer, And we can use max in order to rename the name, but I renamed it to TC01 and then flash AI 0, which means analog input 0, since this thermocouple DAC device has only one analog input called AI 0, we need to use this specific channel name. Then we can start the task using the start function. Then we can start reading the value from the temperature sensor. Just use task.read, which is this function we use to read values from the sensor. Then in this example, I just printed to the console window in Python. And when we are finished, we can stop the task and close the task. So this is a basic program that reads one specific value from the DAC device. So then we are ready. Now I open my Python editor, which is Spider, and the Spider editor is part of the Anaconda Python distribution, which I use in this tutorial. So let's start creating the program. Import and this NiDAC-MX. So now we are ready to use and communicate with the driver. We create this task equals to NiDAC-MX and then dot task like this. Next, we need to specify what kind of task. So we need to start select what kind of channel and task we are going to use. So we just select or create write task and dot, and then part of the Spider editor we have this IntelliSense, so we can choose analog AI underscore channels, which means it's an analog input channel. So select this one, click dot once more, and then we have more choices. And then in our case, it's a thermocouple, so we need to add analog input. We have lots of options here, but we are using a thermocouple, so we need to select this one. And then we need to specify the name of our device, which was TC01, which we specified in this Max software. And then comma, a name of the channel. Oh, sorry, not comma, but here, slash, and the name of the channel, which is analog input 0, like this. So now we have defined or created a task and specified what kind of channel we are going to use. Next, we can start the task. So just task.start, like this. And next, we can create a variable called just value or whatever equals to task.read, like this. This function read reads value from the DAC device. Then we can print it to the screen. Just print value like this. And then when we are finished with the program, we need to stop the task using this stop function, and finally we need to also close the task using this close like this. So this is the final program. We import, start by importing this API. We create a task. We select the channel we are going to use, which is a thermocouple channel, name of the device and name of the specific channel. Typically a DAC device has multiple channels, when this specific DAC device has only one channel, which is analog input 0. We start the task, we start reading from the sensor, print it to the console window, which is here, and we stop and close the task. So let's just run the application by clicking on this run button. And as you see, this is the specific temperature value read from the sensor. So now I can hold on the sensor, and hopefully when I run it now multiple times, and the values from the sensor will increase. So now I'm holding around this temperature sensor, and as you see, every time I run the application, it the temperature gets higher like this. So basically, this is the basic application that you need to create in order to communicate with this DAC device. So in this basic example, you just read one value from the sensor, and every time you want to read a new value, you need to run the program once more, clicking the run button. But typically you want to read or log values from the sensor at specific intervals. So let's modify the program by adding a for loop. So you can create a for loop for k in range n, where we specify number of iterations. N could be 10, 100, 1000, whatever. We can just, for this demonstration, just put n equals to 10. Then the for loop will loop 10 times. So then the value here, we should be inside this for loop, like this. Also the print should be inside the for loop, like this. And let's say we want to log data every second or something. So then we can introduce this sampling time. We can set it to 2 seconds. Like this. And then we can introduce a timer. So we can import a library called time, like this. And then after we have read one value, we can let the program sleep for a period. So we can just use time dot sleep, like this. And the argument here is seconds. So we have introduced this sampling time like this. And finally, we need to, when the for loop is finished after 10 iterations, we need to stop and close the task for this specific DAC device. So now we have modified our example, introducing a for loop, which in this case we means that we are reading 10 samples every second using this sampling time. So let's run this example and see what's happening. And first, the temperature is 19 something, and every second it's reads a new value from the sensor. And now I'm holding around the temperature sensor, and you can see the values are increasing, and it will be run for 10 iterations. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, meaning the for loop goes 10 times. Of course, you can set this to 60, 100, 1000 or whatever, and you can change the sampling time to whatever you need. So basically, this is how you create a basic Python program in order to log data from this temperature sensor. So in this basic example, we have logged values from the temperature sensor. Typically, we also want to plot the values. So let's see in our next example here. I have already made example. I'm, in addition to logging data from the sensor, also plotting the values inside a plot. In order to plot in Python, you typically want to use this matplotlib. So I import the matplotlib like this. We have the same for loop here. I have made some modification. In this case, I want the program to run for a specific amount of time. In this case, I set it to 20 seconds. I specify the sampling time. I create an array of data, which we are going to save the values so we can plot it later. And when I have logged the data and stopped the DAC device and closed it, I'm plotting the values inside a plot. So I just plot T versus the data points. And then I add some titles, X labels, Y labels, grid, etc. So let's just run this application. So every second, it logs value to the console window like this. I also use this rond function in order to have only one decimal. Because this temperature sensor has a limited amount of accuracy, so one decimal point is enough, like this. And here, you see the pops, the plot pops up. Now all the values are the same, but let's keep around the temperature sensors to see if it's the values goes up. So let's start the application once more. I click the run button. Now I'm holding the sensor, and then you see the temperature values are increasing: 9.6, 9.7, 9.8, 20, 20, 20.1, 20.2, etc. And you see, we got this plot based on these values. So now we are getting to something here. Now we are able to log data and we are plotting it. In the next example, I will also save data to a text file. So here is the next example. In addition to logging data from the sensor and presenting the values inside a plot, we are also logging values to a text file. So here, in addition to these previous libraries, the NIDAC-MX API, the time library, the matplotlib for plotting, we also need this NumPy library. The program is almost identical. In addition, we need to open the file we are going to use. So I'm going to make a text file called tempdata for temperaturedata.txt with this write extension. Then I have made a Python function for writing to the text file. And inside our for loop, we are logging data from the temperature sensor. In addition, we are adding it to this array for plotting it. And finally, we are writing the temperature value to this text file. And then, of course, we stop the DAC device. We need to stop or close the file as well, and we are plotting it. So let's just run this example. Clicking the run button. I'm logging values. I'm holding around the temperature sensor to make it increase. And it logs data every second as according to the specified sampling time. And the temperature is increasing because I'm holding around the device. And as you see, here we got this plot with the temperature values. And if I go to my file explorer in the same folder as I'm having this Python file, the following tempdata.txt has been created. Let's just double click to open it in Notepad. And as you see, the values stored in the text file is the same as you see in this plot. So now we have made a complete Python application. We are logging and retrieving values from the sensor. We are plotting it, and finally we are saving the values as well into this text file. So the example I have showed you now works great. It is retrieving values from the sensor. It logs data to a text file, and then finally it shows a plot with the values. But a drawback here, we will see the plot after the logging is finished. So we are not, it is not so easy to plot inside the for loop, because we just put data into this array, and then when the logging is finished, we are doing the plotting. But typically we want to see the plot live or in real time, as we say. So then I have made even a more modified program. Now it's starting to get more complicated, so I will not go into so much details, but I'm using the same libraries. In addition, I need to use the matplotlib animation module in order to make this real-time plotting happen. In addition, I have made a Python function for reading from the DAC, so all things that do is part of this reading from the DAC is put into this function, and all things that are part of the writing to the text file is put into this function called write file data. Then I have some sampling time here, etc. In addition, I need to create an empty figure for plotting, and then I set some titles, labels, etc. as previously, and then we start the logging inside a Python function called logging. And inside here, I'm reading from the DAC device. I'm adding to this array. I have this sleep, so it waits a period, this sampling time. I'm writing to the text file as well. And I'm inside also now, inside this function, updating the plot. And the magic here is this animation function, which we need to use in order to make this happen. And finally, we use this plot show. So let's just run this application and see what's happening. So now I click the run button. So as you see here now, for each logging, reading from the temperature device, the plot is updated in real time. So now I'm holding around the temperature sensor, and you see the temperature is increasing, and also you see the actual value is plotted here in this plot in real time. And this application runs until I just stop this or close this figure. So what I have made now is a real-time application logging values from the sensor in real-time, and at the same time I'm logging to this plot. Also I'm logging to this text file, so this is also continuously updated with new values in each iteration. When I close it now, you see the last one is 59, I just close it, open it to refresh it, and you see it's logging values into this text file in real time. Also the plot is updated continuously based on new values from the sensor. So I can just close it by clicking this close figure. So that's all for now. In this tutorial, I have showed you how you can log data from a DAC device, and I've used this thermocouple DAC device from National Instruments as an example. If you want to learn more about data acquisition applications, either in Python or in other programming languages, you can take a closer look at my webpage, and here you find lots of examples and applications for different DAC applications. If you want to learn more about Python, take a closer look at some of my Python resources, which you find at this location on my webpage. So that's all. So good luck with your Python programming. Thank you.